This is Showtime Sean Porter.
This is Errol Spence Jr.
Hey everyone, this is Jesse Vargas.
And you're watching True School Sports.
You're watching True School Sports.
All right. And you're watching True School Sports.
Stay tuned.
Looking forward to seeing something coming up soon, like maybe like Fury Wilder.
Fury Wilder, definitely.
Okay.
I want to see Demetrius Andre in the next fight on January 30th.
Against Luke Keeler?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good fight night.
Yeah.
Super Bowl weekend.
Will you be there?
I'm trying to get some tickets.
I'll be there covering it.
You going to fight me?
Huh?
You'll take me with you as you get.
I don't know, man. Tickets are expensive because I had a friend buy a ticket. It was like 100 something. Yeah, because they're fighting at like a real bougie resort, like somewhere on an island.
For real?
Yeah, that's at the Meriden, at Island Gardens. I've never been there, but I just hear it's really like high class. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Who do you got, Fury Wilder?
I got a lot. I like that press he did. That was cold.
The presser?
Yeah, that was cold.
What did he say to him?
He was like, oh, you just making excuses. Saying you beat me, even though you got the job.
Oh yeah, he was saying, oh, the best part of the fight was when you got up. You keep talking about that, but you got dropped on your ass.
Yeah, I was like, oh yeah, it's over.
So you ready for that one?
Of course, yeah, but the whole
boxing world ready for that one. So you going wild? Everybody's going wild. I've been asking everybody. Everybody says wilder, wilder, wilder.
But I said wilder in the first fight because he got the equalizer.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to be perfect on a fight for that, man.
Yeah, that's true. Like as a fighter, when you know you got to be perfect for 12 rounds, when you know you had to be perfect for 12 rounds against a certain fighter, how does that weigh on a fighter like psychologically? You think?
Huh?
When you're a fighter and you're fighting a guy who punches like Deontay Wilder, and you know you got to be you got to be perfect for 12 rounds. How do you think that weighs on a fighter psychologically?
I mean, if you're a defensive fighter, you look for the challenge. That's funny.
Yeah.
It's like, oh yeah, I can make this man miss.
I really am that guy.
I'm gonna make sure you never touch me.
Okay.
So from coming from a defensive part of personality, yeah, I look forward to the challenge.
Yeah. And that's
you gotta touch me.
You gotta touch me, you gotta drop me, stop me, and nail me to the canvas.
And if you do touch me, I'm gonna get back up.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's just how a defensive fighter thinks. Like, it don't matter how much power you got. I'm trying to stop you. It's all about the mind. Mind over matter. That's what Tyson Fury proved in the first fight. Yeah, his mind is stronger than his body.
Special stuff in Tyson Fury.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna ask you about one last fight, and I'm gonna let you get back to jump roping. Teofimo Lopez versus Lomachenko when it happens, whenever it happens.
I ain't gonna lie, Lomachenko. Teofimo was cold against Richard Coleman.
He was.
He was cold. So, I don't know, Lomachenko looked slip up or looked spottish in this fight. He can get hurt, but for the most part, I feel like it'll go 12 rounds.
12 rounds?
Yeah.
So if it goes 12 rounds, you got Lomachenko?
If it goes to cards.
Do the cards?
He's the A side.
Okay. So. All right, well, Julien March will be turning pro soon. Looks great, you know? Good to see you again, Julien. All right, so we're here at Fifth Street Gym. We're gonna keep walking around and just talking to people.
Hey, what's going on? It's your boy BT. We're at the Davey Powell, and you're watching True School Sports.